Well, it's a wrap here in Columbus, Georgia, the Tuskegee Morehouse Classic. You might can hear the band just outside of our camera angle here. They are marching out. The game is over. Tuskegee gets the win. A little revenge from last year. Tali Carr along with Shay Omanera. Shay, this game started out with very good pacing, scoring back and forth between both teams. And then that Tuskegee defense kind of stepped up in the second and third quarter.
Yeah, Tuskegee defense stepped up. Two impact players for Tuskegee defense was Brandon Roberts and Ken Hike Jr., two defensive backs who was given Morehouse fits, and especially in the end zone for Morehouse where they struggled multiple times.
All right, let's go back to the late in the, I think it was the second quarter. Morehouse was driving, and they had two touchdowns wiped off on the same drive. They had to settle for a field goal. That was a crazy possession for Morehouse, and it really, maybe I'll say, it took out some of their steam.
Well, yeah, Frank Bailey Jr. had a great game for Morehouse, scored a touchdown, but got overturned by a personal foul because a player's helmet was off for Morehouse. And also, Tramell Gooden had a touchdown pass from Michael Sims, also got overturned because of a holding call. Tuskegee played a great game, Tali, but Morehouse definitely shot themselves in the foot every time they were in the end zone.
And then that was really apparent in the third quarter because they were driving, and you talked about the interceptions Tuskegee was able to come up with. The one that was intercepted in the red zone, that one really hurt.
That one really hurt. Michael Sims threw a pass to the end zone, got intercepted by Brandon Roberts of Tuskegee. He even had two interceptions on the game, intercepting a Hail Mary pass towards the end of the game. And, yeah, every time Morehouse was at the end zone, they would run the ball well. They were running the ball pretty well, but every time they got in the end zone, the offense changed. The offense became stagnant.
Yeah, and you have to give a lot of kudos and credence to Tuskegee. On the offensive side for Tuskegee, Shay, they have a two-quarterback system. Now, I know these guys a little better than you do. I've been following them for the last several years. But we had a chance to talk to them, and let's hear what they have to say, because the 1-2 system for Tuskegee, at least this week and for part of the season, has been working.
I mean, like you said, you know, a lot of people have too much ego. I'm a team guy. I'm a team guy first. You know, like, at the end of the day, I want to win. And, you know, even if you do good and you lose, nobody cares. So at the end of the day, it's a team game. If he in, I'm going to support him. Y'all, I don't feel like you get blessings hating on anybody anyway. So my only goal is when I'm in, do my job. When I'm not, as you can see, I'm first got to go get him every time he do something good. So I just feel like you reciprocate that same energy and good things are bound to happen.
But, you know, starting back in 2016 when we came in as a freshman, you know, me and him, like, we kind of, like, relate ourselves to Jalen Tua. You know, during practice, it's like we competing, like, every down to do what we have to do, or we competing, like, every day to do what we have to do so that we can win, like, every game on the schedule. But, you know, this year, you know, it's been some downfalls here and there. You know, we have to keep each other up no matter what. You know, I always told him, if nobody don't got your back, I always got your back, and I'm 10 toes down. And he know that. You can ask him to this day, and it's vice versa. You know, Ahmad is a brother to me, and I love him, man. Hey, he's a great teammate. He's a great teammate.
And to a man, Shay, it was authentic what they said. I believed them. I don't think it was coach speak or something that they just try to keep the media at bay. They really like each other, and playing together, one coming on, the other going on, the other coming off, the other going back on the field. They don't really seem to have a problem with it.
Definitely genuine, definitely straight from the heart. And then if you can listen to those two interviews, you can see both Jamarcus Ezell and Ahmad DeRamus, they were saying essentially the same thing. The one theme I got out their interviews was teamwork. Teamwork. It doesn't matter if one of them came on and one of them were in the sidelines. They were just focused on winning the game. Even Jamarcus Ezell, he compared it to Jalen and Tua, the other Alabama college team. And how,
I like that, the other Alabama.
Yeah. And like how they were perfectly fine with rotating in and out just as long as they won the game. And that is the same mindset Jamarcus Ezell and Ahmad DeRamus both had in this today's win.
And one thing that they have in common is Peyton Ramsey, the wide receiver. He was the MVP of the Tuskegee Morehouse Classic. We had a chance to catch up with him after the game.
It's game plan. Coach told us all week. We believe. We know we had a rough start this season. We needed this win to get us some confidence moving forward. So hopefully this take us to the next step.
Well, he played a really good game. You know, he's been wanting the ball all year, but I think he's beginning to – before he came to Tuskegee, he only played 1 year of high school ball, so he's finally learning how to become a college football player. And I had a really good day today.
Focus and preparation. That's all we've been working on, focus and preparation. Can't nobody beat us but us. In the last 5 games, we've been beating ourselves, even though the score wasn't like it's supposed to be.
And Shay, we heard from Peyton and his coach and his grandfather, Coach Slater, and they both acknowledge he's still learning how to become a college player. Only 1 year of high school ball. That's pretty dangerous considering the type of game he had today.
Yes, Tall, that is very scary because the physical talent that Peyton Ramsey has already and the fact he only had 1 year of high school football, the sky's the limit for Peyton Ramsey. Sky's the limit.
They got a win, still trying to stay in playoff contention. I always ask you this, Shay, if you guys haven't had a chance to meet Shay yet. Shay is from the non-HBCU life in college. You went to St. John's. You've been to a few of these HBCU games so far. Your impressions today, just the vibe here at the Tuskegee Morehouse Classic.
Well, the vibe here is great. And it's not just about the football game. It's also the game within the game, the battle of the bands. Even after the game, they were battling against each other. And in my personal opinion, I feel like Tuskegee not only won the football game, they also won the battle of the bands as well.
All right, pretty bold here. Look at Shay. He's picking winners here. So it was a really good time here in Columbus. For Shay, I'm Tolly. Thanks for hanging out with us, as always, here at HBCU Game Day.